Not too long ago, I was dancing for dollars. No, it's really real if I let you be my mama. You don't want a girl like me, I'm too crazy. Where every other girl you meet is bougazy. I'm sure them other girls were nice enough, but you need someone to spice it up. So who you gonna call? Cardi, Cardi, come.
Somebody who can love me at my worst. No, I'm not perfect, but I hope you'd see my worth. Cause it's only you, nobody knew I put you first. And for you, girl, I'd swear I'd do the worst. Stay forever, let me hold your hand. I can feel those places in your heart, no what else can. Let me show you love, no, no pretend. I'll be right here, baby, you know I'll sink or swim. Oh, don't you worry. I'll be there whenever you want. I need somebody who can love me at my worst. No, I'm not perfect, but I hope you'd see my worth. Cause it's only you, nobody knew I put you first. And for you, girl, I'd swear I'd do the worst.
I've been shaping lately, focusing the things that didn't make no sense. Guess that growing up was never meant to be easy. Yeah, I got used to doing everything sideways. Didn't really care about how everyone felt. Hiding my emotions down in different ashtrays. Oh, but what if the loss ain't gone? Just let go, cause it's a part of you that will make you strong. Embrace your flaws. I'm not gonna fight back what I've become. Yeah, I got bruises where I came from, but I wouldn't change if I could restart. I ain't gotta hide these beautiful scars. I've been going way too hard on myself. Guess that is the reason that I'm feeling like hell. But I wouldn't change if I could restart. I ain't gotta hide these beautiful scars. I went down a road that only got me nowhere. I've seen every corner, every inch of this place. Being all alone, it really got me thinking. Maybe overthinking that what is lost ain't gone. No, you can't just let go, cause it's a part of you that will.
देखियो चाहत Ji, and welcome to everyone to this wonderful Sunday morning here in the U.S. And other times in other parts of the world. I know there are people from Kenya here, from Nepal, of course from the U.S. and from India. So we're all in different time zones. Hopefully this is not too late for people to join. I know that it is quite late in India. But the good thing is next month, around the first week of next month, the time will change in the US and it will become 1 hour earlier for people in India. So it will be a little better at that time. I know this is quite late for you. So just wanted to welcome once again, Namaste, Rajiv Lakhanpal ji, Acharya Anupam ji, me, as usual, driving to her work and signing on. Maabha, hello. Kena ji, Mr. Kena from Kenya, I would assume. Dr. Budhi Raja, namaste. I like your headboard. Ashish Pajaji, pranam. I see Sushila ji, hello. Karunanatosh ji, I saw him just a minute. Yes, he's there. Hello, Karunanatosh. Chari Kunj Bihari ji. Lillian, Shweta, Manjeet Kaur, hello. So welcome to everyone in this wonderful Sunday meditation session that we have every Sunday here in the US. We have a very special guest today, Acharya Anupam. This is not the first time he is joining us, but I think it's the second time, I believe. And I remember it was an amazing session the first time that he did for us. And We're very excited to have Acharya Anupam once again with us. Unfortunately, I don't know too much about Acharya Anupam. That's one of the things that happens when you live in the US and you're trying to coordinate things by speakers from India. So all I know is he's a very prolific Acharya from Oshodhara, and he conducts meditations in the ashram as well as online. I have participated in a few of his online meditations, as well as I've met him in Oshodhara. I don't think he would remember me, but I have seen him in the Murthal ashram. So I know he lives in Ambala, and please, Acharyaji, correct me when I'm wrong. But I know that he is an amazing Acharya. So without much delay, I would hand over the spotlight to Acharya Anupam to take us away into satsang and meditation. Thank you.
Thank you, Nikesh Sethji. Thank you very much for such a lovely introduction. There is nothing much more to know except that I am one of the disciples of Sadhguru Osho Siddhartha Holiyaji and a grand disciple of Param Guru Osho. So that is more than enough. What lovely introduction can be there than that? So thank you very much, and very warm greetings to all my lovely friends who are connected on this beautiful morning and evening somewhere, and it is night somewhere. So my best greetings to all of you. So to begin with, let us first pray to the Almighty and the Masters. Join your hands together, close your eyes, and remember the Master and the Almighty all around us. And let's pray. Oh God, please take us from unreal to the real, from darkness to the light, from death to the immortality. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Rub your hand together. Create a warmth within and caress your eyes and face and other parts of the body. My dear, lovely, wealthy friends, life is energy. And we are all small pieces of that energy. That energy is conscious, isn't it? It is its conscious nature which has taken us to this beautiful world. We have made so much progress. It is because of that nature of energy which is consciousness. It is the stream of consciousness, the rays of consciousness which make us know the things and make us discover the things and make us to know each other, to know a wonderful, vast knowledge of science and medical science and all other sciences, all other body of knowledge. It is because of that consciousness. And the masters, the sages, the avatars say that life is a journey from that total energy, from outward world to the inner world, from outer space to the inner space. And this is what spirituality is. Sadhguru defines spirituality that spirituality is a journey from outer space to the inner space. This is what a meditation is as well. Meditation is a journey from outward to the inner world, from the outer space to the inner space, from the world to our own self, our inner being, or it is also called deep intimacy with ourself. When the energy, this piece of energy, comes to know itself fully, completely, it is called realization. It is called enlightenment. It is called meditation. So we are on this journey from the very childhood, but we are not aware of it. So today, we have to become aware. And for this, we have to know what is awareness. What is this awareness, this awakening, which makes us alive, which makes us love, which makes us work, which makes us to know everything which we know. So can anybody share what is this awareness, what is this awakening, which makes us connected with each other, which makes us to joy life? So what is this awareness, if anybody can share? What do we mean by awareness? Yes, Nikesh ji, please.
Yes, I think awareness is, again, as a very, non-complex way that I think of it, is a fact that we are, or I am, for example, I am not just this body that, or, you know, someone that who is this body. It's, I'm more than my body. I am part of this cosmic universe, and me and a tree that is growing in my backyard are not different. We're part of the same consciousness. That's the way I would think awareness today, as I'm thinking.
Wonderful.
Thank you.
Great. Anybody else?
I would say when we talk about awareness, it's basically, I think it means to me, is you're aware of situation, emotions, yourself, others. Because, you know, like sometimes people get angry, they don't even know they are so angry. But once you are aware, at least you know that that's happening to you or to happen to others. So emotional awareness, I guess.
Wonderful. That's great, Abha Singh Ma. So yes, Ashish ji.
Pranam Swamiji. For me, awareness is my existence, and I am knowing about my existence. That is awareness. If I know all the time that I am existing, that is awareness. Wonderful. Otherwise, my mind is out, my emotions are out, and I am not aware about myself. So when I am knowing that I exist, that is awareness.
Wonderful, wonderful. That's great, Ashish Bajaji. Let's make it very simple so that everybody can understand it. We know that we have just understood that we are all consciousness, we are all energy. That part of energy, that part of consciousness, which comes to know about person, place, and things, that is awareness. That part of energy, the consciousness of our being, which makes us know the things, which makes us know the persons, which makes us to realize something, which makes us to feel, which makes to makes us feel hunger, thirst. That part of that total consciousness is called awareness. Intellectuals have said that, have given it name, the stream of consciousness. The stream of consciousness which goes to the things, to the persons, to the places, and brings us the information about that person, place, and thing. That is awareness. I think it's clear. Awareness is that part of our consciousness, that part of our being, our existence, which makes us know the things. Suppose we are sun. We are sun in the sky. How do we come to know about the earth, about the crops, about other living beings, about vegetation on earth? the rays from the sun comes down and take the picture of that or give life to that vegetation, to that earth, to the people living here. That rays, those rays of sun can be called the awareness of that sun. The sun is the consciousness, and the stream of rays comes down to know the things. Same is the case with our own being. We are total consciousness as a whole, total energy, a piece of energy, as I said earlier. And the rays of energy, the rays of consciousness, which goes out of us and bring the information back to us, that is called awareness. So it is this awareness that we travel with. This awareness takes us on a journey. If we go by foot as well, it is because of that energy. That energy takes us from one place to the other. This energy makes this hand up and down. Not total energy, something of that energy, some rays of that energy, some piece of that energy. So this is awareness. And it is, we said that spirituality is journey from outworld to the inner world, outer space to the inner space. This awareness naturally is outward. Our eyes open outside, our hands touch from outside, our ears listen from outside. The nature, the existence, the Almighty has made it outward, other-centered, other-oriented. So it is outward oriented. We have to bring it back to our own self. As if the rays which sun sends on the earth, it calls them back towards itself. This is what spirituality is. This is what meditation is. So we have to understand a certain terms of this awareness. We have to make steps. We have to make milestones so that the journey becomes easier and interesting. The first step is, as we have already said, that is active awareness. What is active awareness? Other-centered awareness. The part of energy which goes outward, which goes to a place, which goes to a person. That is active awareness. Why is it active awareness? Because it takes us, takes something from our total consciousness. It is active. It brings some information. It falls on some place, person, and things. And what is passive awareness? The second term is passive awareness. The awareness is passive when it does not go outward. When it doesn't go away from us, when it is not other-centered, when it is self-centered. So we may bring it to our book with an experiment, a small experiment. Let us do that. You have some picture on the wall? Some picture or some point, if not, then just look at me or the picture behind of Sadhguru or any other on the window. Just look any one of us or the picture on the wall with yourself. And see that some energy is going out of you and falling on that particular person, that particular portrait, or on the portrait of Sadhguru, or any one of us in the window of our laptop or mobile. some rays of energy, some stream of consciousness is going outward. You are looking somewhere. You are concentrating on something, on some person, some picture, or on your own TV or laptop or mobile. Now, let us reverse it. Imagine, feel, think that particular person, that particular picture is looking at you. This person sitting before you, or the picture hanging before you, is looking at you, smiling, happy. Stream of consciousness from that picture, that person is coming towards you. The rays of consciousness are falling upon you. He is looking at you, smiling with bright eyes, smiling face, as if he is very happy to look at you. Now, let us share which experiment make you feel better when you are looking at something, someplace, or some portrait, or when that person was looking at you. What was the better one? Dhiraji. Dhiraji, please unmute. Yes.
The picture looking at me.
That was more soothing, more comfortable, more beautiful. Yes, wonderful. When the master or when the person sitting before you were looking at you, you were feeling better. Yes, very good. Abhama?
Yeah, same experience.
Same. When rays of consciousness were falling upon you, you felt better.
Mm-hmm.
Wonderful. Yeah. Raji ji. Someone was speaking.
When you are looking at somebody, when you are looking at the pictures, when you feel good.
Okay. When you were looking at picture, you were feeling better. Right. Wonderful. Anybody else?
Acharyaji?
Yes.
Acharyaji, I felt that Sadhguru's, there was some golden rays, golden light coming towards me.
Wonderful. When you are being looked at, when somebody was attending you felt
yes,
better.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Yes.
Palak? Palak is listening. Dr. Buddhi Raja? Okay, you are unable to unmute. Yes.
Yes. When the other person will look at me, I will feel more smoothing.
Wonderful. We see that we had 5 to 6 sharing, and only one fellow, only one friend of us felt better when he was looking at something. When rays of consciousness were going out from him, he felt better. But rest of us felt better when someone was looking at us, when the blessings and love and the attention of others fall upon us, we feel better. This is passive awareness. In active awareness, what happens in active awareness? Something is extracted from us. Something is taken away from us. We are getting mitigated. And that's why we get tired. If we are remembering our mother, our Guruji or the Almighty, something is going out of us. We are tired, we become tired. And when we feel that Sadhguru is loving me, blessings of mother are falling upon me, my friends are taking care of me, the whole nature is so kind to me, I feel better, I feel loved, I feel blessed. So it is this passive awareness where the inner journey starts from. We have started making inner journey. The moment we feel that God is loving us, God is taking care of us, He has given in abundance to us. It is He who is taking care that we may breathe, we may taste, we may see. When we feel like this, that we are being loved, we are blessed. This is passive awareness. Active awareness we have understood. When something goes out from us, some rays of light goes out from us, we are becoming lesser and lesser energetic. Energy is seeping away from us. And when somebody's energy is falling, there are two things. We are conserving our own, and others' energy are falling upon us. So something is being added to us. We are becoming something plus, something more. That's why we feel better when mother looks at us, when friends give attention to us. We are a sort of irrigated. We are being nourished. We feel nourished when somebody attends to us. The third term is objective awareness. First is active awareness, when energy goes out from us. Then passive awareness, when energy comes to us back. Our energy is with us and someone else's energy is falling upon us. Someone else's attention, love, blessings. We can give all are the names, different names of energy. We feel nourished, we feel blessed, we feel loved. We feel complete. That's why we feel better. This is the joy of meditation. We receive the energy of the whole cosmos and nothing is going out of us. This is passive awareness. Then is objective awareness. What is objective awareness? When the energy within us falls upon the activities which are going on with our body, in our mind, in our heart, that is called objective awareness. Because all the thinking which are going on in our mind, all the actions which are going on in our body, all the feelings, love, desire, compassion, anger, all these things are objects. They are the objection between ourselves and the joy we want to go to, we want to feel. So when the energy, that consciousness falls upon these things, that is called objective awareness. Let us experience it. Close your eyes. Sit comfortably. And just feel your body. Feel the weight on the floor, the bed, the chair you are sitting in. Guess what is your weight? Feel the touch of the seat you are sitting in. bring all your awareness to the fit. To the legs, to the thighs, the lower body part. Bring it very slowly to the middle part of your body, your navel area, your chest, your back, shoulder blade, both the arms, neck, throat. Bring all your attention to the face, both the eyes, nose, lips, forehead, the whole of your upper part. Awareness is on a journey. Now bring it to the breaths coming in, going out. Yes, Anutosh ji, you may play soft music. Energy is on a journey. It has come from body to the breaths. Watch your breaths coming in, going out. Breath comes in, navel center rises up. Stay there for 5 to 10 seconds and it starts coming back. Navel falls, the breath is outward. Consciousness is all aware of it. Again, the breath comes in. Make the stomach elate. Reverse back. Comes out. The navel area is deflated. And we are feeling more and more peaceful, silent. Calm. And relaxed. Feel the relaxation, the peace, the silence. You are surrounded by. Now take this awareness to the thoughts in your mind, if there is any. Bring all your attention. Gather all the rays of consciousness which have turned into awareness to the waves of thoughts rising upon the sea of the mind. It is a matter of great surprise when you start becoming aware of the thoughts, you find they are not there. You feel as if you are thoughtless. Now bring that energy, that awareness to the feelings. How do you feel right now? How do you feel? It is cold, it is hot, it is soothing. Come to the feeling. Feel the temperature. Feel the mood you are in. Feel the touch. Feel the smell if there is any. And you are in your original being. You are now and here. This is all objective awareness you are in. You are all in objective awareness now. We have to move from here to the meditative awareness, the meditation which we are all on a journey to. Now, you have come from the body to the breaths, from breaths to the thoughts, from thoughts to the feelings, and now to the no man's land, where there is nothing. There is no body there. There is no thought there. No breath is there. And neither are there any feeling. What is that no man's land? That is the inner space before your closed eyes. With your closed eyes, you are watching something. It may be blackness, darkness. It may be reddish, redness. Whatever it is, you are feeling something. You are looking at something. Something is there in awareness. Sages call it inner space, heart of the heart. An English poet calls it the heart of the heart. See, there is no thought here, no feeling here, no breaths here. It is no man's land. In the outer space, there are birds, clouds, planes, houses, suns, earth, and so many planets, so many actions going on. But in this inner space, there is no action at all. No form. See if there is any form. There is no form here. So formlessness plus awareness is meditative awareness. See, is there any thought here? There is no thought. Thoughtlessness plus awareness, it is meditative awareness. It is in this meditative awareness that we feel bliss, we feel joy, we feel blessed, we feel complete. The next milestone is total awareness. Now be there. Be there in that inner space. And with the help of your imagination, with the help of your remembrance, with the help of your mind, come out. Come out to the outworld. People, places, things. Remember the roles you are in the outer world. You are a brother, you are a father, you are a friend, you are a fellow worker. But within you are this emptiness, this inner space. You are aware of both the world together, inner world and outer world. Remember the task you are doing in your daily life. And keep on looking into this inner emptiness, inner space. You are centered and revolving around in the outer world, doing your daily courses. Helping your family, friend, society, serving in many ways, but knowing that you are this inner conscious space, this inner being. This is total awareness. Lord Krishna calls it witnessing, sakshi. You are well aware of all your roles and responsibilities, friends and relations, duties, everything. But you are also fully conscious of your original being, real being. You know that only some part of your consciousness, some stream of consciousness goes out and finishes the daily courses. but your real being is this which you are now centered in. This is total awareness. Something going out and a lot of, more than 90% is conserved, is all together here in inner space. It is this total consciousness which through the eyes sees the world, through the ear listens to the songs, listening to this music, listens to your family and friend, through the tongue tastes so many delicacies, and through the skin touches the outer world. Now feel that you are touching the outer space from all your skin. Skin is the biggest sense which you have. Suppose the outer space is touching you. It's not a matter of supposing. It is actuality. But now you are feeling it. Normally you don't feel it, but now you are getting enveloped, you are surrounded, you are embraced by this conscious outer space and you are feeling it. You are having a very soothing touch from all around your body, through the skins. This is total awareness. The next milestone is subjective awareness. Now forget all about outer world. Get back your imagination, visualization, thinking. Drop it down to this inner conscious space. Don't let it go. Be here and now. Just see. You are not aware of anything. Any person, any place, you are just awareness. Just awareness. Suppose there is light and no object in the room. The light of your consciousness is falling nowhere. It is there. Just think that you are consciousness and nothing to know, nothing to feel, nothing to touch, nothing to see. Pure consciousness, a pure being. No ray of consciousness is going out. It is all together. Composed. Feeling nothing, thinking nothing, seeing nothing. Pure awareness, just awareness. Not even the joy. Not even the goodness is being felt. Pure energy, just awareness. It is the state there, which we call the divine abode. Not even the joy, not even the bliss is there. Total inactivity. Total passivity. But there is no joy. The energy, the consciousness can't be that passive, can't be joyless. It has to come into action. It wants to joy, it wants to be blissful, it wants to be related, it wants to expand, it wants to go out, it wants to blossom, bloom, flower. So it has to go on outward journey. It has to go to outer space. This is what is called divine remembrance, Sumiran. So let us go to this divine remembrance, to this state of blissfulness, to this state of joyfulness. To the state of bloom, gloominess, blossoming. Make use of your mind now, your imagination, your feelings, and feel that you are all surrounded by godliness, the celebrating form of nature. The nature has engulfed you, has surrounded you from all around. Make use of your breathing. While breathing in, inhaling, feel that this consciousness, awareness, is coming out from all of your pores, follicles, and getting merged into the outer space. And while breathing out, feel that this outer space, the godliness outward, is embracing you, taking you into its arms, loving you, blessing you, and you are feeling blissful, loved, blessed. Make it as slow as possible. Breathe in slowly, slowly, and feel that many rays of consciousness, awareness are coming out of your pores, where from the sweat comes. It is now energy, it is now awareness coming out and getting merged with the outward world, with the consciousness. And with incoming breath, with outgoing breath, feel that this conscious energy is falling back upon you, embracing you, loving you, nourishing you, and you are blissful. You are full of joy. You are enjoying. You are a loving child of God. He is caressing you. He is taking you in its lap. Join it with your breaths coming in, going out. This is divine remembrance. With incoming breath, feel that you are embracing godliness. You are merging into outward space. And with outgoing breath, feel that this outer space is engulfing you, embracing you, loving you, caressing you. And come to the feeling. You are so pleased. You are feeling so much loved, so much blissful. A sense of thankfulness is getting gathered in you. You are all senses now. With incoming and outgoing breath, you are swinging from godliness to the original being of your own self. With incoming breath, you are merging to the godliness. With outgoing breath, you are enjoying your own self. You are overjoyed. Slowly, slowly, let's now come back to the outer world. We have tasted the elixir. We have seen what is deathlessness. It is this sense of being which has no death. It is always there. It has been there and it will be there. When the body will not be and when the body was not there. This inner conscious space and outer godliness actually are one. It is always there. So being deeply aware of this fact, you may now take 2-3 long and deep breaths. Move your fingers and toes. Feel a rush of energy through all the parts of your body, from toes to the tip of the head, and come to the outer physical world. Join both of your hands together and bring a sense of thankfulness and gratitude in your heart for the Master, for the Almighty, and pray to the Lord, O Lord, let the fruit of our wisdom, our experiment of this meditation, be allocated to all the beings on the earth. Let all be happy. Let all be healthy. Let all be blissful. Rub both of your hands together. Feel the warmth between the palms. And rub them on your eyes, face, and rest of the parts of your body. Thank you very much for participating in this experiment. And now let us share it, because the more we share, the deeper the experience goes and it increases. The bliss when shared gets doubled, and the sorrow when shared gets half. So sharing is very important in both the cases. If you felt better, it will become more and more better. If you did not, it will lessen. It will come down. So please share. Rashmi ji.
Acharya ji, I felt very, very light and very fresh. Oh my God. It's very light, like floating.
Wonderful. That's great.
Very light.
It's floating. I remember. It's floating. We were talking about the feeling of outer space. It's a bad luck of humanity that it is unable to feel nowadays, as birds can feel in the outer space, as trees can feel the outer space while swinging in the air. We don't do. As children, when they are happy, they just extend their hands and feel the space around. That is the bliss. So we...
It's like I'm gliding.
Yeah, yeah. So in this kind of experience, we come to that original feeling, as birds would be feeling the outer space, as trees are feeling the outer space, as children, small children are feeling the outer space. That we have to feel. Because it is the space within and around us. We are more than 99% spacious.
Spacious. Thank you. Thank you.
Good.
Gratitude.
Ji. Next. So, will I have to name? Right. Ravi Lakhanpal ji, can you share something? Rajiv Lakhanpal. Yes, you are on. Yes. You again get muted. Once again, just touch and leave. Yes, yes.
Hello. Namaskar ji.
Namaskar.
I felt very, very deep inside somewhere. Don't even feel like talking right now. It was just, can't express. It was like the whole body just, I wasn't even aware of the body, just feeling insights.
That's good.
Concentrated on one place.
It's very hard to bring to the words. Feelings bringing to the world is difficult. Wonderful. Yes, great. Thank you. Dheeraj ji. Right.
I feel very better. I cannot express it, you know, in the world. What can I say you? Thank you so much.
All right. You felt like journeying, like traveling somewhere.
Yeah.
Yes. Good. Peter Maes. Peter Maes can share something. Your feelings. Pramila Tripathi. Kennedy Ho. Yes, Pramila Tripathi is unmuted.
Pranam. I felt very good. Thoughts were there. They're coming and going, but I was not concentrated on the thoughts that I feel good. Other time, I just stuck on the thoughts, but this time I was not stuck. They were coming and going. I was able to.
Yes, you were on journey. You are not staying. So, yeah, right.
Yes. Yes. Thank you so much.
Good. Ivans. Ivans. Kena. Kena ji. Anybody wants to share? Lilan. Okay, then. Yeah, Peter Maes. Peter Maes, welcome.
Oh, thanks a lot. It was a good experience.
Right.
And it was quite good.
Good.
I felt like I was somewhere.
Good.
Yes, yes. Thank you.
Wonderful. Okay. Pradyuman Pandeji. Kennedy Hodge. Yes. That's up. Unmute Kare. Please unmute yourself. Yes, yes, yes.
Yeah, it's a very nice experience.
Wonderful.
Yeah, enjoy.
Good, good. Okay, you. Let's go to Ashish Bajaji, Nikesh Ji. So over to you.
Thanks a lot, Swamiji. It was a wonderful experience. I was feeling like that I was traveling to Samadhi, but it was great, great experience. And I thank all my friends who have joined from Kenya. So thanks a lot to all of them. And it was a great experience. Very nice. Thank you.
Thank you. Ji, Nikesh Ji.
Thank you so much, Acharya Anupam Ji. This was one of the most deep experiences I've had. So as Acharya Ashish Ji was saying, that it was like Samadhi, going into Samadhi, which is the way I felt as well. However, when I've gone into Samadhi in the past, it has been not this much guided the way you did it. It was like I would go on my own, but I would be like floating all over the place, thoughts coming and going. It used to be like, was I somewhere else? Where did I go? And then 45 minutes later, I find myself back. This one was more like there was a soothing sound of your voice guiding us and telling us what exactly is happening. And that just was a very new experience for me. Although I have done, dhyan and samadhi before, this was a very powerful kind of guided kind of samadhi experience for me. So thank you so much.
That's great. Wonderful. I did not let you go into samadhi. I took you immediately from the place where samadhi could happen.
Correct.
Because it is not a samadhi session, and it should be given 40 minutes at least there. So I didn't let you be there. I just took you there and brought you out from that
place. Yeah, I was expecting to go into samadhi, and
right.
I was going there, and then you brought us back. So
yeah.
Right.
Yes. So we have to come back to this very world. So any final word you have to? So I'm very pleased to be with all of you. I enjoyed it a lot. And it's again over to you to finish or say something.
Thank you so much, Acharya Anupamji. I just explained my experience just a minute ago. So I don't want to add anything to that. I just want to live that experience the rest of the day. But we are very grateful for you to join us and do this session in completely in English. It's one of the best English sessions we've had in our US sessions. And we really, pray to you that you join us again and again. We'd like to have you on our Sunday sessions as much as you can make it. You're always welcome. Anytime you feel like maybe you want to see us again, just let us know. You're always welcome. So thank you so much to you. Thank you to all the participants for attending the session as well as sharing. As Acharyaji was saying, sharing is very important in this journey. And that's why we have these sessions, to be together in our journey. By yourself, it's such a new experience, such a non-traditional experience that we have in our regular lives that you don't really know what is happening, or there's a good chance that you will get a little lost. So having a guidance like this and a group of people who are on the same path is extremely helpful. So please keep joining, and with a little nice music, we'll call this a day, and we'll see everyone next weekend. So thank you, Acharya Anupamji, and thank you to everyone.
Thank you. So nice of everybody. Sharing is caring. It might seem crazy what I'm about to say.